Hi guys, welcome back. If you are trying to access UEFI firmware settings on your Windows 10 or 11 PC but can't find the options, don't worry, you are not alone. Many users face this issue, and today I will show you how to fix it so that you will be able to access UEFI firmware settings without any problem. So let's get started. Here I am going to show this on one of my Windows 10 PC, but don't worry, the procedure is exactly the same for Windows 11 as well. So first, let's check if the UEFI firmware settings options is missing. So right click on start, then go to settings, navigate to update and security, and then go to recovery. Under advanced startup, click restart now. Once your PC restart, go to the troubleshoot, then click on advanced options. Here you should see UEFI firmware settings, but if it's missing, that's the issue we need to fix. Okay, this usually happens because your system is running in legacy BIOS mode instead of UEFI. So let's confirm that now. To check if your system is in legacy mode, go to the start button and type system information. In the system information window, scroll down to BIOS mode. If it says legacy, that means your system is not running in UEFI mode. Now let's check the partition style of our disk to confirm whether it's running MBR instead of GPT. So for that, you need to press Windows plus R on your keyboard and type diskmgmt.msc and hit enter. Then find disk 0, usually the system disk, and right click on it and select properties. Then go to the volume tabs and check partition style. If it says MBR master boot record, then we need to convert it to GPT. As you can see, my disk is running the MBR partition style. To fix this issue and enable UEFI, we need to convert MBR to GPT. Don't worry, I will show you the easiest way to do this now. So open command prompt as an administrator. Here you need to type one command, mbr to gpt space forward slash convert space forward slash allow full OS. The process will start and you should see a success message. This command converts your system disk from MBR to GPT without losing data. I have put this command in the video description, so you can copy it from there and paste it directly into your CMD window. However, if you get a validation error over here, don't worry, I have made a separate video explaining how to fix it. You can check the link in the description below for that guide. Now, we need to reboot into BIOS and change the settings. So restart your PC and enter BIOS setup. Usually press F2, F10, F12 or Del depending on your system. Then look for the boot configuration or boot mode settings in your BIOS. And disable legacy support and enable secure boot. Make sure that boot mode is set to UEFI. This means you are switching from legacy BIOS to UEFI. Keep in mind that different motherboard manufacturers may have different menu options for this set. Once done, save the changes and restart your PC. After rebooting, let's verify if the changes have been applied. So open system information again. Under BIOS mode, it should now say UEFI. Great. As you can see, our system is now running in UEFI mode instead of legacy. That means we have successfully converted our system. Next, let's check the partition style again. So once again, press Windows plus R and type diskmgmt.msc and hit enter. Right click on disk 0, then go to properties, then volume, and check partition style. It should now say GUID partition table GPT. And here's the final confirmation that our disk partition style has changed from MBR to GPT. Finally, let's check if UEFI firmware setting is now available. So go to the settings, update and security, then go to recovery, then click restart now. Now navigate to the troubleshoot, then go to the advanced option, and there you go, UEFI firmware setting is now available over here. You can see now you can access UEFI firmware settings without any issue, And that's it for today's video, guys. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment below if you have any question. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.